Welcome to your first act with the BenQ Board. If you are a new BenQ user, or you just want a refresher of some of the basic features and functions, this session is perfect for you. The first thing we'll go through is logging into the panel. You have several easy options for logging into your account on the board. On the board, you'll have a login icon. Once you open the login window, you can click QR code, manually type in your email, or if you're utilizing an SSO, such as sign in with Google or a Microsoft account, Classlink or Clever, you can tap that to manually log in as well. When tapping the QR code, you'll just use a mobile device and the camera to scan the app and sign in with your credentials. Or you can use an NFC card if you have one. To utilize the NFC card, you just tap the N logo on the front of the panel and it will log you into your BenQ account. With your panel, you have two styluses. One has a thin side and one has a thick side. You also have a remote with all of the buttons to easily access and utilize your board from anywhere in the room. You can quickly go to the home screen. You have a spotlight and a laser. You also have the manual power button as well as the volume buttons, and you can navigate between all of your recent applications. You can also quickly get to the home screen by utilizing the panels on the buttons on the front of the panel. You have the home button, the back button, and your manual volume buttons as well. But in addition to the physical hardware that you have to easily get to your home screen and go back to recent applications, you also have the floating sidebar. This sidebar, I am just moving up and down, and it exists on both sides of the board. This sidebar makes it easy for you to quickly go to your home screen. You can also go to all of your recently used applications. You can also navigate between your three recently used apps to quickly go back and forth. You can always access the EasyWrite whiteboard, the floating tool, and you can freeze your screen all from the sidebar, no matter which side of the board you're standing on. You'll notice here on my board, I have customized my apps for the ones that I use the most, and I put them where I want them. You have the option to customize your board as well. All of your apps are in the little All Applications icon in the center of the board. This is where you'll see all of the apps that have been downloaded to your board. You can easily customize these apps by holding down and clicking and dragging and dropping wherever you want that app to live on your board. We also have a tab for widgets. This is where you can grab a clock, a calendar, maybe even a sticky note, and you can click and drag your widgets to also go to the home screen as well. The third tab is your bookmarks. You can preload bookmarks through your AMS account so that when you go to the board and tap on the bookmark, it takes you straight to that website. No need to go to your Chrome or find all your bookmarks or go search up that resource. All of those resources that you utilize every single day, you can quickly grab just from the bookmarks bar by customizing that in your AMS account. To customize your AMS settings, you'll log into ams.benq.com. Once logged in with your credentials, you'll see that you have a variety of settings you can edit. You can customize your wallpaper. You can customize your profile photo. You can also add bookmarks by tapping Edit and Add. You'll type in your bookmark name, copy and paste your URL for that resource you use all the time. But one of the most important things in AMS is linking your cloud drive. Whether you use Google Drive or OneDrive or another cloud drive resource, by linking your accounts here, it makes it so that you can easily access and save resources to those cloud drives directly from the board without ever having to open the apps. The digital whiteboard is called EasyWrite 6, and this is the application. On the EasyWrite whiteboard, you have lots of different elements to teach on the fly, to bring in your own content, as well as save your content directly to your cloud drive. As I mentioned earlier, you have two styluses with the board. While I can use my pen to write in handwriting on the board, I can also use my fingers as well. These boards are multiple points of touch, so it will recognize when you have several students at the panel working at the same time, as well as just utilizing multiple styluses or having to write multiple colors at one time. When I write something in my handwriting on the board, I have a couple of options with my pen here. I can use the select tool to select my word, and then it gives me this menu. You'll start to see that a lot of the menus look exactly the same, whether you're working with a text box, an imported image, or even a shape. These things are very intuitive to your use, so that way it's a lot easier for you to get the hang of utilizing these tools. I can tap the easy icon, and it's going to turn my handwriting directly into text. I can also tap the speech icon,
hello,
and it will read it aloud. I can also tap the translate icon and translate languages. To adjust the spoken language or the translated language, you can just hold down on the translate icon, and then you can choose for another language package of your choice. I also have a menu that pops up here with my text box. I have lots of different options. I can trash this and delete this. I can lock it. I can also easily copy and use the clipboard to paste. Or I can duplicate, or I can use the infinite clone. My infinite clone is now going to give me as many options as I want with having an infinite amount of resources. Similarly to how I wrote the text, I can also draw a shape with my pen. So if I draw my circle here, I can use my select tool to select that. I can tap the shape icon, and it is going to turn that into a perfect shape that closely matches what I drew. I now have all of those same options where I can lock, I can throw away, I can also change the color here to fill it in, and then I have all of those options such as duplicating or having infinite clone as well. One thing with the EasyWrite is its ease of navigation. You'll notice at the bottom, I've been working from the pen in your main toolbar here in the center, but over on the right-hand side, this is where I can see how many pages I have in my whiteboard at this moment. Right now, I'm on page 1 of 1. I can tap the plus sign, and now I have 2 pages, and it started a new page over for me. I don't have to worry about losing everything on my last page because I can just hop over to the new page and start fresh from there. I can also navigate my pages from this menu here. I can quickly drag and drop if I want to rearrange. I can also duplicate the page, or I can insert a new page. So if I want to insert a new page in between, I tap the 3 dots, select new, and it's going to insert a page in between those 2 pages. With the pen tool, you have a couple of options. You've got the normal pen, which is what I've been using to write. You can also switch between, so here's your pen. You can also switch with the highlighter. I can also have the dual pen mode, which allows me to have 2 different colors at one time. As I mentioned before, your styluses have a skinny tip and they have a thick tip. I can take one side of the pen and tap 1 color. I can take the other side of the pen and tap a different color. Now, when I write my notes, and then with 1 color, and I flip the pen around, I can now circle or underline or do something else with another color. This is also great when you have multiple students at the board. You can give each one the different size pen, or one of them can use the pen and the other can use their finger, and it allows them to write in 2 different colors at the same time so that it's easy to distinguish which students are doing which work. You also have the teacher toolbox all the way to the right on the main side, on the main menu. In this toolbox, you have resources such as a timer, a stopwatch. You also have a random spinner. When you're using this toolbox, some of the tools have this icon right here. Those are floating widgets. So now when I tap that, it's now a floating tool. I can move this around. Even when I use my home button to go back to my home screen, that floating tool is still going to be there. And also in the toolbox is our Google integration. We've got Google Drive and Google Chrome here. When you tap one of those icons, it will auto split your screen. So now I'm looking at my EasyWrite and I'm looking at my Chrome browser. It will have your recently used tabs. It will keep them open so that you don't have to go find a whole new tab and go access all those resources. If you already had those resources open in Chrome, when you split your screen with Chrome, it will open all of those tabs that you had available. So now I can utilize my resources in a split screen. To change your split screen, you can make this side a little bit bigger, and so now my whiteboard is a little smaller, just by utilizing the black bar in the middle to drag. If I want to completely get rid of my split screen, I can just pull all the way to one side, and it will open the app back in full screen. I can also access my Google Drive from EasyWrite as well. So now I've got my Google Drive in split screen, and now I can access all of the resources to have on the ready. This is especially helpful when you want to have your Google Slides in presentation mode while also utilizing your whiteboard. It just gives you a lot more functionality to be using multiple resources at the same time. One last thing with EasyWrite is, now what do you do with this lesson? You've now created some different resources. I've got 5 pages here of notes and annotations I've modeled for my students. So now what do we do with this? On the bottom left side, you have the hamburger menu, the 3 lines, and you have a share icon. You have a lot of different options here to share this resource. Maybe you just want to share this one page as an image, or you want to share it as a PDF because you want to drop it into your Google Classroom or into Schoology so that your students can access it later, or especially for all those students that may be absent. I've got lots of different resources here. When I choose to save it as a PDF, it's going to ask me, which pages do I want to save? All of them, I can select. I can pick and choose what I want to save. It's going to ask me to give it a name. And now I can choose if I want to save it directly into my Google Drive, or I can choose AMS because maybe I use OneDrive. When I tap AMS, it's going to take me to this window where now I can choose to either save it to my Google Drive, my OneDrive, or even directly to the board. That saving feature will work exactly the same way, regardless of the type of file you're saving it as. If you want this file to continue to be editable, or you want to share it with some of your colleagues in a shared drive, then the best way to save this resource will be to save it as an EasyWrite file. That will keep it in the EasyWrite file type to make it easy to open on another panel if you're teaching in another classroom, or if your colleague wants to use the same lesson for later. Another resource utilized primarily on our BenQ boards is our wireless casting feature. We utilize the app called InstaShare 2. The InstaShare 2 app comes on your panel and can be downloaded to any device. The app lives in the Google Play Store, in the Apple Store, but you can also download the software directly from our website for any device. When you open the app on the board, it's going to give you a pairing code as well as your board name. You then open the app on your computer and you're able to type in the pairing code or select your board name. You can also share without using the InstaShare app on your device by utilizing the native casting features of your device. So if you have a MacBook or an iPad, you can use the AirPlay function. If you have a Chromebook or an Android tablet, you can utilize the Google Cast. You can also utilize Miracast if you have a Windows device as well. Using the InstaShare 2 app is going to give you the most functionality of your device when casting to the board, so that's what we recommend the most. I'm going to connect my computer to this board, and I'm going to share my device to the board, so you're going to start to see that it's going to mirror my device. You can now see my computer screen. One of the main benefits of using the InstaShare 2 app and casting from the device to the board is that I now have full touchback. You're viewing my computer screen, but I can still control my computer from the panel. I have full touchback from the board, so I no longer need to be standing at my computer. I don't have to extend my screen. I don't have to worry about what's being shown on this screen versus my computer screen. I can manage all of that from here, and my computer can be at my desk. Once you're casting through InstaShare, you will see a little default InstaShare 2 icon. It will come down here to the lower right-hand side. These are your host controls. This is where you can quickly see who is casting to the board. You might have multiple devices casting at one time, and you'll see the list of names. There's an eyeball right next to my device. If I don't want to show my computer at the moment, I can tap the eyeball, and it's going to hide my device. So now I can function on my Android screen. I can go back to my Google Chrome tab. I can open all of those resources and quickly go back and forth between those and InstaShare. By utilizing my side menu, I can tap InstaShare, open my host menu, and turn my board back, my computer back on. I can also just tap the home button and go back to my home screen as well. I can utilize my Google Drive. I don't have to worry about retyping in that pairing code with my computer, because even though I'm back on my home screen, until I physically disconnect my computer or end the session from the board, my computer is going to maintain that connection. So now I can just tap on my side menu, tap InstaShare, and it's going to bring my computer right back. One of the features that teachers love the most about InstaShare is its ability to have a floating window. Using that host control, I can tap floating window, and my computer is now in a smaller window. So I can open my EasyWrite, I still have my full touch back over here, and I can also open my resources directly on my computer screen from here. So now I'm running my computer within my floating window. So you'll see my resources pop up here. I can also adjust the size of this floating window by dragging from the lower corners. And so now I have this resource and I can use both at the same time. To go back to full screen, I just tap the smart split icon. It's going to take me right back. Again, you're looking at my computer. But one thing that is really helpful here is our floating tool. You'll notice on the bottom left, there's a circle icon with a pencil in the middle. That is our floating tool where you can use it for annotations and additional tools and resources. I can quickly grab that floating tool and bring it to this side by holding two fingers down on the board, and it will bring that floating tool right to me. Now I can use my pen and I can write my notes. I can grab my highlighter, highlight this section. Notice that I'm not actually annotating on the image. I am just putting an overlay on here. So on my computer, this worksheet isn't changing at all. But when I open my floating tool, those annotations are going to stay here. When I want to clear my annotations, I just grab my eraser. I can do erase all. But maybe I want to save my work. I've now modeled how to do this. I've pointed out some different resources. I can use the camera icon on the floating tool to take a screenshot. And now I can screenshot this image and I can either save it to my Google Drive or I can even send it straight into EasyWrite. So it just took a picture of my computer screen with my annotations and it put it directly into EasyWrite. I can quickly go back to InstaShare with my side menu. You can still access all of the tools from the floating tool as well. So when I was in EasyWrite, I mentioned that there's a timer, there's a spinning wheel, all of those kinds of resources. You do still have access to the toolbox right here, so I can quickly grab that timer that I want to use. And again, I've got the floating widget icon, so now I have two different widgets that are floating, and I can utilize those other resources in the toolbox on the floating tool as well. If you have any questions about anything you've seen throughout this recording, please be sure to jot those questions down and come to our live webinar on September 9th at 3:30 Central Time to ask us all those questions that you have and how to utilize your resources on the BenQ board. See you soon.